Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. You are all very welcome along to this, the virtual Patrick O'Keefe Traditional Music Festival 2020, coming to you live from Castle Island in County Kerry. This is a very strange festival for us this year, obviously, because we can't hold a physical festival or have our friends and musicians in Castle Island for the weekend, which is making us very sad, I have to say, but it is what it is, and hopefully next year we'll be all back in person and we'll be able to enjoy it to its full. We have a full programme of events on for the festival. I won't go through them now because I'm sure it's too long, it would be too long-winded, and it's all available on our website, and if you found me, you'll have found the website. I would like to thank the following sponsors, without whom our festival could not have happened. The Arts Council of Ireland, particularly, under the auspices of the Department of Cultural Heritage and the Gaeltacht, the local 2020 Local Festivals and Summer School Scheme, Kerry County Council's Community Support Fund, the Kerry County Council Arts Act 2020, and finally the Kerry County Council and Fáil d'Éireann's Festival and Participant Events for the County of Kerry 2020. I would also like to thank our local sponsors who have supported us fantastically down through the years. This is obviously an extremely difficult year for them. And when things reopen, I would encourage all of you to shop local and support your local businesses, because that's what keeps rural Ireland going. I'm going to tell you about tonight's events. First of all, we're going to have a few words from Eoin Sam O'Sullivan, who is the Sleabhe Lucra musician in residence. This is followed by a few brief words from Kate Kennelly, the Kerry County Arts Officer, who we are very grateful to for her support through the years. After that, we're going to have a virtual session with four different groups, which will take us up to about 8 o'clock, and then we're going to have Nicky McAuliffe in conversation with Eoin Sam O'Sullivan, and the name of their piece is called The Tune, The Title and The History. So first up in the virtual sessions is Raymond O'Sullivan, Timmy Connors and Eoin Sam O'Sullivan from Newmarket, County Cork. And after that we have Billy and Mary Norman, again from County Cork, Bohorbui, followed by Con Meinen and Dennis Connor, local Castle Island men, great stalwarts of the festival, and followed by PJ Teagan, Mick Cullity and Sean Abeta, great friends of the festival as well. So enjoy the rest of your night and enjoy the rest of the weekend. There is, like I say, it's all available on patrickmcgeefestival.com. So enjoy your night. And without any further ado, I'm going to play the first note of the festival myself. So good luck. Thank you.
Hi, Eoin O'Sullivan here. I just wanted to say well done to the Patrick O'Keefe Festival for putting in such a big effort, and good luck with all the events over the weekend. I'm going to be out doing that Sleabhe Lucra musician in residence job again this year, and some of the younger viewers I might see in the schools, and I'm hoping to start a little record company putting out Sleabhe Lucra music, and I'll be doing a few online concerts as well, so please look out for those during the year, and just have a great weekend. Castle Island is one of my favourite places to go to meet friends and make friends as well, and hear great music, and really looking forward to being back there again, and enjoy everything over the weekend and in the meantime. All sails aloft. Okay, bye.
Hello, I'm Kate Kennelly, the Arts Officer and Creative Ireland Coordinator with Kerry County Council, and I'm here to wish the very best to the Patrick O'Keefe Festival for 2020, to the organisers, the musicians, everyone participating, and to you, the audience, for reaching the festival in a new way this year. It's been a challenging year for everyone, and particularly the arts sector, so thank you for joining, and I hope you all have a wonderful festival. This festival celebrates the very best of the Sleabhe Lucra music tradition, which is in itself very special and deserves to be remembered and celebrated through this festival.
Hi everybody, this is Mary from Tom McCarthy's, missing all my old friends this October weekend. Hope to see you all next year and all our old friends back again for bigger and better. part of your Cleef weekend. Stay safe until we meet again.
Hi, my name is Muala Curtin here in the Shoemaker Bar in Castle Island. I'd just like to say that normally this time of year we're in full preparation for the Portugal Cleef Festival. It's been the biggest event of the year in Castle Island, probably for the past 25 years. I'd just like to say we really miss all the patrons who come every year to Castle Island for the festival, and also the musicians who have come from all over the country and actually all over the world. I know 2021 will be the biggest and best festival of all, so we look forward to that, onwards and upwards, and we look forward to seeing you all here again next year. So until then, the very best of luck to everybody, and take care, we'll see you then.
Good evening everybody, Thomas here from the Crown Bar, Castle Island. I hope you're all keeping well during these challenging COVID-19 times. Unfortunately, we don't have the Patrick O'Keefe Festival this weekend. We have a slimmed down version on the internet, but we won't see all your smiling faces here with the fun and the crack in the bar. We'd like to send out all our best wishes to our great friends and musicians. So on behalf of myself, Thomas, Daniel, and all the staff and management at the Crown Bar, Castle Island, we'll see you all in 2021 at the Patrick O'Keefe Festival, please God. God bless, and thank you all from the Crown.
The Gana, we meet a Ulru, the Fela, Padraki Kiv, Gahara, then Okada Vina Gina, Kunana Gaelga, being Kupla Fuckle, August, Pop Up Gueltat. Up for your Emlina, the stream to COVID Nadiog, need me able to unload agro Emlina. But Chin Tadima Oring Mar. Bimer Exul, the Bolamid Leonard Carter, Miguel Gori, Agus, Kior Tori, or Kiri, Agus, Gakat Kunde, Kuigamon, Agus, Tevamuda, Kuigamon. Agus, Blienta, being Dini Kotori on rank, the band Tavanche Gaplian, the on rank. Agus, America, being Dini. Now, Andrade Viegrin, or the Cora, kind, cure, August crack, August day. Salashti, mean tea, August coffee, August. Biok Anala, Egon Yegin. Either sleep, Dini Og, Augustine Easter, August Winner, Galer Antanova, so I mean says, Demarker, Imlina, Nevexia, Shinna Shore, but Ta Kursi Bogarai, Augusta, and Krishna Town Rod Facebook August Zoom, so it all fairly big show in Lena, it does know a more of the Hina. So that's what I'm going to go Benig Dini on antenna of us on a Skalak.
Greetings to everyone from Browns Bar in Castle Island. We're so disappointed this year that our festival is not going ahead, but albeit online, and we hope to reach out to all the fantastic customers from all over the world and patrons who travelled year in, year out. We're going to miss you all this year, and we'd just like to say hope you're all well and that we'd love to see you again next year. Please God.
Hello, this is Fagan here from Hatton's Bar, top of town, Castle Island. We're sad to say that we'll probably go Cleef this year, and we'll miss all the musicians from north, south, east and west. And of course from all over the world who come to Castle Island and York for a weekend. But sure, look, next year, 2021, hopefully we'll be around drinking pints and talking and making good friends and whatever, and you know, we'll have a bit of crack and a bit of cure. Take care and be safe.
One, two, three, four. So myself and Billy are going to start off with a set of slides. The first one is called A Slide for Kevin, and then the second one is called She Didn't Dance and Dance.
Right, and four. 1, 2, 3, 4. Concert and for having us.
Thank you. welcome to Patrick O'Keefe 2020. Hello to everyone out there who was joining us for this. We're going to play a few jigs, Atmos in Winter and the Galway Jig,
right.
Two of Paddy Cronin's tunes. And Dennis and I would like to remember another Paddy tonight as well. Remember Paddy Jones, who passed away during the summer. Good friend of ours, good friend of the player. So play those two jigs. On the thing.
Thank you. So, good evening and welcome to our little talk this evening on the tune, the title and the composer. I suppose it's a part of Irish music that's really not looked at and maybe should be looked at. But for the next half hour or so, we'll have a look at a few tunes, I suppose, with historic connections with world events and world figures. So the first one we did there came from, it's a polka in the Sliva Lucra area, and it's also a reel. And it comes from the Petrie collection, about 1855, and it's a tune, I suppose, that would be collected before the famine. The box about the fireplace. Known in Petrie's collection as a monster reel. Now it's played, as I said, around the Sliva Lucra area as a polka, and many years ago I heard Sean O'Reilly's Cúl Thráthcún playing it as the reel. And I suppose it's good that we have the Petrie collection, because a lot of tunes in Petrie were collected before the famine, which is very important, and the music was not lost. Now we'll move off a bit further and down South Kerry to a man, national figure, MP, Daniel O'Connell. Now, I doubt if Daniel O'Connell ever played music, but there are at least six, seven or eight tunes associated with Daniel O'Connell, because of his, he was a famous MP and a famous Kerry man as well, of course. And he was elected in 1828 as an MP for Clare, and there's a great tune composed by a Galway piper, Paddy Keneally, in 1828, and it's called O'Connell's Welcome to Clare. He was elected an MP for Clare, and there's a great story about the man that, we'll be coming to that in a minute, the man that proposed him for MP was a man by the name of Tom Steele. And Tom got his name into a reel as well. So it's very interesting when you look at this side of music. I suppose many years ago, a great Hungarian, Zoltán Kodály, put four characteristics in music. A well-trained hand, a well-trained ear, a well-trained heart, and a well-trained intelligence. So I suppose this might be a part of the intelligence part of music, because we have a lot of musicians out there with the other three. So we'll play O'Connell's Farewell to Dublin now first, and it's a sit dance, and it came from a great fiddle player in County Clare called Patrick Kelly. So we'll give you an example of one of the tunes associated with Donald O'Connell, and it's called O'Connell's Farewell to Dublin. I presume it would be after, on his way to London for his meetings in the House of Parliament.
Thank you.
But a tune, I suppose, that you would hear in a session in Scanty Glen or Castle Island or Killarney or County Clare or County Galway. And a great old reel, and it's called O'Connell's Trip to Parliament, I suppose, again, after one of his trips to, again, to London, to the House of Parliament. So... come to, I suppose, O'Connell was on his way to Rome in 1847, and he died on his way to Rome in Genoa in 1847, and his words were fated, my body to Ireland and my heart to Rome. But there's a great lament, and this is slowing the whole thing down. There's a great lament and composed as well, and it's called The Good Old Woman's Lament for O'Connell, a very nice piece of music.
Yeah.
So we'll, in honour of O'Connell, we'll he's dead now, and buried it in Glasnevin, and so we'll give you O'Connell's...
They never brought him back to Kerry, Simon?
No, he's buried in Dublin, in Glasnevin, in a big tower. There's a big, huge tower inside the gate in Glasnevin, and this the Good Old Woman's Lament for O'Connell. Talking earlier about Tom Steele. Tom Steele was the man that, as I say, proposed O'Connell for MP for Clare, which he won in 1828. And Tom Steele was a man from Tulla, County Clare, and they were great friends. And he was in London when O'Connell died, and on hearing of O'Connell's death, he jumped into the Thames. Now, he didn't die from the fall, but he died a short time after. Now, there's a tune called Tom Steele's Reel, and we were talking about names earlier, with tunes with a couple of names. Now, it's in one collection called Hand Me Down the Tattle. Now, it's made its way into O'Neill's Music of Ireland, 1907, as Tom Steele's Reel. So I presume this is after Tom Steele. So that's how... tunes got their name from figures, very...
Yeah, yeah. They gave them topical names, kind of, didn't they?
Exactly. Yeah. They were the men of the day, and they sounded great tunes for the collectors and for the composers.
Yeah.
You know, and we don't know who composed a lot of those tunes, you see. The composers was lost.
Yeah.
That weren't mentioned, and which is the opposite to classical music, where the composer is first,
and the
music is next. So you know. Back to the Donal O'Connell again, a piece we forgot, and I just thought about it. And a very important part of Irish history, I suppose, was the Act of Union in 1800, where the Irish Parliament was cut out for good, and we were totally on our own with England. And Donal was always there to repeal the Union. I suppose it finally came, and along with Catholic Emancipation in 1829. And again, the composer was out, and a great read called The Repeal of the Union, and for Donal O'Connell. Now we'll move on, and I suppose we'll go to another world figure, and Napoleon Bonaparte. And a lot of tunes have been written about Napoleon and in the Irish repertoire. And two famous ones, is Bonaparte's Advance and Bonaparte's Retreat, which was about a famous battle in Moscow. This also ties in with a classical composition, of course, and the Russian, great Russian composer Tchaikovsky wrote a thing called the 1812 Overture. So we have a classical story and a traditional story about the Battle of Moscow. And I suppose Napoleon, of course, was commemorated as well in the song tradition with a great song called The Bonny Bunch of Roses. So we'll give you a sample of the Advance first. Then after every battle we have the retreat. So here goes Bonaparte's retreat. Another man big in the Irish tradition is Bonnie Prince Charlie, a Scotchman. A lot of tunes called after him as well, and we have a few here now. Great favourite in the Slievelucher area was a great six-part hornpipe, Johnny Cope. Again, we're all talking about battles around 1745, around that time, Bonnie Prince Charlie. And Johnny Cope, a famous hornpipe. It's also a polka in the Roach collection. And we have a polka here, Eoin, you'll play for this. And it's a great polka, and it's got lots of names, words as well, called the Hundred Pipers. Now, the story is that Bonnie Prince Charlie's forces were leading to battle in Carlisle, in Scotland, and leading the army were 100 pipers. And it's also played, I've had it played as a waltz in Cape Breton. And it's played as a slide around Slievelucher.
Yes.
And waltz this as well. So we'll give it a go. Another tune associated with Bonnie Prince Charlie is the Blackbird, the famous set dance, the Blackbird,
yeah,
which is also a famous song in the Irish singing tradition, the Black My Royal Blackbird,
yeah.
And Bonnie Prince Charlie was the person in question in the Blackbird, but he had to be written under an assumed name, because at the time of the penal laws, you didn't mention names.
Yeah.
It's dangerous.
Yeah.
So they were all written under assumed names. So Bonnie Prince Charlie is the Blackbird in this tune and in the song as well.
In this, I suppose, and you know, Dennis Murphy played the Blackbird as an air.
That's right. It's also an air.
It's taken from the song, or
a good question.
Yeah.
Yes. I think maybe the air will come first. I think the air is in the Roach collection.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, as the air, you know, and it's there as the set dance as well.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Which came first?
Yeah, yeah.
They're both great tunes, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a famous tune. So we'll give the Blackbird a go.
Did you? Well, here in the crack, sir.
Thank you.
Now, we have a very interesting story again about this time. We seem to be going to battles and disaster all the time. This is a tune called The Rights of Man, a great old hornpipe, which you're going to hear in any session and maybe for playing for polka sets as well. The Rights of Man was a great hornpipe at the end of the set here in East Kerry and North Cork and all around that country. Now, there's a great story about that. A man by the name of Thomas Paine wrote a book, and it was about 2 years after the French Revolution, and he was in favour of the French Revolution, and he wrote this book called The Rights of Man, where he sided with people who demonstrated against governments who weren't treating their citizens properly, and hence the book The Rights of Man, and a man by the name of Thomas Paine. Now, another Irishman, an Irishman, Thomas Paine was an Englishman, I think, but an Irishman, Edmund Burke, who was an MP, I think he, Paine was all for the French Revolution, but I think Edmund Burke criticised the French Revolution. So, anyway, that's politics. No. Now we'll come to the end of our tune, story, and composer, and this is a very interesting tune, and it's probably the newest of all the stuff we've been talking about for the last 30 minutes or so, and we're going to place in Calendar, in Ontario, in Canada, and in 1934, five girls were born. And they were the first quintuplets to survive in Canada. And they were known as the family of Dionnes. And Canada, of course, being great fiddle country, Quebec, Ontario, or Cape Breton, around that area there. So some composer decided he would write a five-part reel and a part for each of them. Would have been played a lot by an accordion player from Kenturk, Jackie Daly, played it with the Buttons and Bows. I think that would be the first to bring it out. And it's played a lot, as I say, in Canada. And we'll give you a little snippet of thank you.
I started like this.